So the new graphic novel Stranger Things Summer Special One-Shot just released yesterday, and it's a single-issue comic which takes place during the events of Season 3, and I'm going to explain how the graphic novel and the show connect. Here's a synopsis of the graphic novel from the Dark Horse Comics website. Officers Powell and Callahan patrol the mean streets of Hawkins, Indiana with the enthusiasm of two hefty dachshunds pretending to be bloodhounds. Typically, they don't have to chase down more than the occasional petty theft and troublemaking teens, but lately the town has been getting weirder, and while they might not get to the bottom of it, they just might be lucky enough to survive it. In the show, right before the graphic novel takes place, Billy drives to meet Mrs. Wheeler. However, something hits his car and he gets out, only for the Mind Flayer to drag him down to the Brimborn Steelworks to possess him. It seems most likely that this is when the comic takes place, because the day after the first part of the graphic novel is when people are protesting outside Mayor Klein's office. This means that it must start on June 29th, as the next day has to be the 30th, because Mayor Klein says Independence Day is in 4 days. The graphic novel says July 1st, but I'll prioritize the show over what the comic says and just assume they made a small mistake. The graphic novel starts with Officers Powell and Callahan driving to the Brimborn Steelworks building. They say, "Our quiet night just got a little more noisy," which I'm guessing is the sound of Billy crashing his car and something smashing through his car windshield, which is likely the reason they were called to investigate in that area. They arrive and find Billy's car, and they suspect that he went into the building. They see some rats running by, which are likely being controlled by the Mind Flayer to help form the spider monster. As the officers go to enter behind them, Billy enters his car and drives away without them noticing. They start to head back to the car to grab flashlights, and Powell gets gunk stuck on his shoe. Part of the Mind Flayer's gunk slithers out from the basement behind them, which they don't see, and they head back to the car before it can do anything. They then notice that Billy's car is gone, and they head to the Waffle House to eat. Powell takes off his shoes and leaves him behind with the monster gunk crawling away from his shoes. At the Waffle House, Powell and Callahan eat and discuss the weirdness of Hawkins that has been happening since Will disappeared. Officer Callahan recalls that last Halloween, Florence Scott calls about a demon dog running around, and he thinks that some drunk clown slapped a costume on his mutt and set it loose. He suspects that Scott Clark did it. This demon dog was very likely a demo dog and could have been Dart or possibly another demo dog that escaped from the Upside Down. The weird thing is, I don't see any other signs of a demo dog in the Halloween episode. The only signs is Dart, which Dustin finds at the end of the episode, which I'm not sure if that's from at the end of season one, where the Will, like the slug-looking thing, that could have been Dart, or maybe it somehow escaped from the lab and there were others out there too, I don't know. Officer Powell brings up how Barbara went missing just right after Will went missing, and Callahan says since the lab took responsibility for both of those things, that the mystery was solved. Powell implies that it's not that simple and that he's seen some shit. Callahan says weird things happened in every town, and everything gets explained eventually, and that Hawkins is no different. Gregory, Alexi, and another person get out of a car near the officer's car at the Waffle House. The next day, Officer Powell goes to the town hall to try and shut down the protests, and he radios Hopper and says he needs to get there right away. Callahan comes later because his stomach is trying to kill him because he got the clam fritters at Waffle House. Gregory shows up and goes to enter the town hall, but Callahan stops him and says he saw him at the Waffle House, and he asks him if he got the clam fritters. Gregory escapes and goes into the town hall, and the officers go to confront the crowd and tell them to stay back from the town hall. An hour later, after Jim arrested and got rid of all the protesters at town hall, Officers Powell and Callahan get a call from Flo that they got reports of disturbing noises at 4819 Cornwallis Road, which is where Mrs. Driscoll's house is, and Hop wants them to perform a wellness check at the house. They go inside the house and walk down the stairs into the basement and find fertilizer and a trail of blood on the floor that leads up the stairs. Callahan leaves to go to a dentist appointment, and Powell starts to get woozy. Mrs. Driscoll says she added extra love to the lemonade, which means the lemonade was probably poisoned, because he passes out and Doris drags him into his car and drives him to the steelworks factory. Later, Powell wakes up in his car and sees Tom and Bruce in front of the car, who tell him to join them. He backs up the car and leaves. There's a few things here that don't really make sense. I'm not sure how Doris got back home because this was the same night that she was later found by Nancy and Jonathan eating fertilizer and was rushed to the hospital. Maybe she went inside the Steelworks building and somehow got home later, or she possibly walked home. Also, another thing that doesn't match up is that Tom and Bruce are out there at the factory when in the show they don't get flayed until 2 days later. On the same day as the protests in the show, Billy brings Heather to get flayed, and then the day after is when Tom gets flayed. It can't be later because it's raining, which it was in the show, and the day after in the graphic novel, the officers talk about Doris eating fertilizer and being taken to the hospital the night before. There are also other people at the factory trying to convince Powell to join them, which doesn't make sense because other people besides Billy wouldn't get flayed until later. Anyways, it doesn't really matter that much, but it's just kind of strange. The next day, Officers Powell and Callahan find the hole in the brick wall at the pool and they go inside to look around. The place is a mess and there's a lot of glass everywhere. They find a hair and they think it could be Billy since he lifts weights, which means it could have been him. They leave and try to go talk to Hopper. Flo tells them that Hopper isn't there. Flo then tells them that they are covering Mayor Klein's funfair. She says that they need to cover the funfair tonight, but the timeline doesn't match up exactly, so I'll just assume the writers made another timeline mistake and just skip to July 4th when the funfair is, regardless of when the events before take place. So at the funfair, the officers are walking out at the same time Alexei and Murray are walking nearby. Callahan gets a corn hog, and then one of Grigori's henchmen bumps into him and he drops his corn dog. They debate if they should stay or not, and they say there's nothing going on there. A girl comes up to them and tells them, there's a man sleeping on the ground over there, which is really Alexei, because he got shot and is lying on the ground, bleeding out. They just tell her that they are taking a nap, but don't actually check. The girl also asks if they've seen her aunt, and they go with her near the bumper cars to try and find her aunt. Also, the girl's name is Jamie, which is the same name of test subject number 9 at Hawkins Lab in the Stranger Things 6 and Enter the Fire comics. And she looks similar, but I don't know if it's the same person or if they're related. It's probably just a coincidence. They leave the funfair and drive to the Starcourt Mall, hoping to see Back to the Future, but it's closed, and they see a car and Billy is in it. They stop the car and ask Billy to pull over and shut off his engine. Billy responds by kicking open the door and kicking Powell, also grabbing Callahan's neck and throwing them both back and then speeding off. Callahan looks towards the Starcourt Mall and sees a giant spider monster crashing through the ceiling and starts to run. He calls Flo to send everyone and everything to the Starcourt Mall. Powell goes up to a nearby car with teens in it to check for license and registration, and they speed off and they get in their car and start to chase after them. In the distance, the mall explodes and they pull over. At this same moment is when Joyce pulls the key and makes the gate explode. Lots of helicopters fly overhead, heading towards the mall, which is Dr. Owens and the U.S. military. Overall, this was a pretty good graphic novel, and it was cool to see Officer Powell and Callahan's point of view during these events in Season 3. However, there were several inconsistencies with the show, with the date and the timeline not exactly lining up, and several things just not making much sense. It would be nice if they paid more attention to the show to make the comics more accurate, but it's not really a big deal. Even if they don't fit in with the show's timeline or are considered non-canon, it's still cool to see more of the Stranger Things expanded universe and more of the characters and other storylines that they don't have time for in the show. Anyways, that's the end of the video, and I'm working on a complete chronological timeline of Stranger Things, including the graphic novels, books, and other media, and I'm going to make videos on it eventually when I finish it. So bye, and like and subscribe if you enjoyed.